version 2, part 2. I wasn't sure what to call this version, so I will just call it version 2S. S stands for slightly different. To the left is the original version 2, and on the right is the revised version. I already talked about version 2 in my previous video, so here I will only talk about the changes. And if you haven't seen my version 2 video, I recommend that you pause and you watch that one first. So what didn't change? The design, the schematics, and the code. This revised version is mainly about the choices I made in the components, specifically the switch and the battery. Let's start with the battery. Originally, I used a coined battery, the LIR2450. It worked great, but there was a small limitation. It was part of the sensor design and it was built right into the PCB itself. But soon, I started experimenting with different variations. So I creating a motion sensor and a temperature sensor. The coin battery can be sufficient for doors in low traffic rooms with its limited 100 milliamp hour capacity. It definitely became an issue with more demanding sensors, like a temperature sensor. So I thought it would be a good idea to decouple the battery from the sensor. So this gives me the flexibility to pair the sensor with properly sized batteries for the application. So instead of housing the battery on the PCB, I simply added connectors for the battery, and this is what you see on the side here. The second change I made was the input switch. The switch determines the door status, and I originally used this read switch. Technically, it was fully functional, and it did what it's supposed to do, but in practice, it wasn't great. Let's start with the housing. It's made out of glass, very thin glass. This thing broke easily. I don't even remember how many I destroyed while soldering them to the PCB. The glass shatters the moment you bend the legs. Second, for the read switch to work, it needs a magnet to go along with it, and I have to pay attention to the alignment and orientation of the magnet. Another thing I have to worry about is the adhesive. Usually I put the magnet on the door, and if it's not fixed properly, it can easily fly off if the door slammed by accident. The new switch I picked fixed those two issues. It's called a micro-switch. You might recognize it from 3D printers. Actually, this is where I got the idea. Those micro switches are robust and don't require any external components, eliminating the magnet and the issues that come with it. And since it's part of the sensor, it is fixed to the door frame and not the door itself, with only the arm moving. The micro switch comes in different versions, the straight and right angled, right and left. I am using the right angled version, so the arm sticks to the side facing the door. I also made a very basic 3D printing cases for it. It has a small opening to let the micro switch arm stick out. When the door is closed, it compresses the arm connecting the signal to the ground, and when it's open, it connects it to VCC, just like the read switch. And this is how the sensor looks like installed. I've had it running for almost a month now, and it looks like this battery should last over a year with the current usage. It uses very few microamps in standby. So that was a quick summary of the revised version 2. And as usual, I will link to the schematics, source code, and everything else in the description. But before you go, let me show you something. This is version 3. And if everything goes well, this can be the first version that I will be making available on my store. I know a lot of you ask for this, and I am working hard on that. So let me know what you think in the comment section, and thank you for watching.